Hello and welcome to the second class of our After Effects Expressions course. This class is about the most famous, most popular, and also one of the most simple expressions, the wiggle. As the name suggests, you can use it to wiggle things, but also to create this explosion. To wiggle the position of a layer, as for all expressions, we first Alt or Option click on the stopwatch. Then we enter wiggle, and then in parentheses, we give two numbers. The first number says how often it wiggles, say 2 times per second, and this one is called the frequency. The second number says how much it should wiggle and is called amplitude. It is separated by the first one with a comma. So we enter comma 300, which will let it wiggle up to 300 pixels in each direction. If we change this number to 20, it wiggles much faster, now 20 times per second. If we change the second number to 30, you can see it just wiggles a little bit, up to 30 pixels. Actually, the second value is more like a guide value. In 99% of the cases, the wiggle will not move more than the given distance, but in rare cases it might also move a bit more. So the wiggle is a bit buggy in that respect, but in practice this usually doesn't matter. And most people don't even notice this. Instead of entering numbers manually, you can also link the parameters to other properties, like a slider. So let's create a slider on the layer by going to Effect, Expression Controls, Slider Control. Expression controls are effects that do nothing. They just provide a slider or other user interface element to link your expressions to. We duplicate the slider and give them meaningful names like frequency and amplitude. Now let me quickly add some line breaks to our expression. This does not change the meaning of the expression at all, but helps us to see better what's going on in the next steps. We select the first number in our expression, which is a frequency, and with the pick whip, link it to the frequency slider. As you can see, the number now has been replaced by some expressions code that says please use the value of the frequency slider for this parameter. Now we select the second number and link it to the amplitude slider. The expression we created looks pretty complex and maybe a bit scary, but with the help of the pick whip, creating it was rather simple. If we now change the slider, the wiggle updates accordingly. We can even keyframe the amplitude to fade the wiggle in and out. And since we are talking about keyframes, although the layer is now moved by the expression, you are still able to keyframe the position. The wiggle will then act on top of the keyframes, or in other words, will wiggle relative to the keyframe motion path. An interesting special case of the wiggle is when we set the speed or frequency to 0. This means the layer should not wiggle at all, but still the wiggle will give the position a random offset. And if we duplicate the layer, you can see that for each instance this random offset is a different one. So this can be very useful to distribute layers randomly. Let's use this idea to create an explosion. I have a bunch of layers here and already applied a wiggle to their rotation. As you can see, it rotates 25 times per second up to 360 degrees. In other words, at each frame we get an entirely different random rotation value. Now let's also wiggle the position. We enter wiggle, open parentheses, and as first parameter we enter 0, since we don't want the wiggle to move, but we just want a random placement. Then we enter comma, and as second parameter we use a pick whip to link it to the slider I already created here on this null layer. Finally, don't forget to add the closing parentheses of the wiggle after the code generated by the pick whip. Oh, and by the way, expressions are case sensitive, so make sure to write wiggle all lowercase. Now I copy the position to all the other layers such that they all have the expression too. By the way, if you only want to copy the expression but not the keyframe values, you can also right-click on the property and choose copy expression only. But here the position of all layers is identical anyway, so it doesn't really matter whether we only copy the expression or the entire property. If I now move the slider, you can see that all layers move away in a random direction. I already prepared two keyframes on the slider to animate the value starting at 0 and then increasing quickly. A nice aspect of this technique is that when I start duplicating my layers, each new instance will get a new random placement. So it really saves you a lot of time if you deal with a lot of layers. So that was the wiggle expression. Now that you've seen a first example of writing expressions code, in the next class I will start giving you a bit more systematic overview of the expressions language. In case the next class is not yet published, please subscribe to our newsletter. because in the newsletter we share all our tutorials for free already before they are published, such that you can see them before everybody else. Again, this is Matthias Möhl for MarmorWorld.com. See you next time.